Hello and welcome back to Vigo Playing. As always, Space Wagon Manager. So, last time we got all the funding we ever wanted. And we are looking very good for getting even more budget next time. Yeah, I mean, look at that jump. So yeah, and all of my people are busy expect for 6 flight controllers who are already badass. So what I decided to do last time is open up the biosatellite program that I once opened and closed. And yeah, they are at 95.5% reliability. This is the maximum R&D reliability too, so I could not even put 4 people there if I even wanted. And so yeah, my Gemini is now 82% reliability, and oh no, it will be because which is pretty nice, but no, I don't have flight controllers ready enough to open. And the boosters are 82 and 81. And so yeah, what I have devised is to do a biosatellite extended mission, which will occupy and occupy my flight controllers. And so yeah, what I had to think is to use the Centaur or the Atlas. Well, this is a kind of risky launch. I just checked it, but I can check it again. The Atlas will be 81% reliable. The Titan is just a little bit better, 82.8% higher projected, so not really much different. So yeah, I could just launch the biosatellite with the Atlas, and that will occupy well, 5 of my flight controllers in the first turn and 4 of them in the second and third turns in theory. And yeah, it will get us 1000 prestige. And so maybe and we also overtake the Soviets in a way, since they did the regular mission the first time, so they are ahead of us. 150 the amount we get. Although once again I see, so that gives us a little bit. So this would give us 37. Still I don't get how it comes up to 250. Let's see, so second 130. Yeah, that this goes up to be 189. So, but this is strange because I already did this. And I was already the second party to do this. So I should get this prestige point in theory. But well, whatever. So what we will do is an extended mission that will give us 1000, at least the game proclaims to give us 1000. We should keep in mind we have 25,400 prestige right now. So yeah, and yeah, it will if we see this will increase our booster reliability quite nicely. If we fail, it will downgrade it, but that's not that bad because we still have the other booster going for the Gemini, so we can recuperate if we lose out of reliability here. So yeah, I'm going to schedule this mission. Yeah, it will cost off a lot, and right now it's below 80%. But it will get above 80%, so this tooltip warning is not important. Yes. And of course, I have the 6 very best people already ready. Well, the very best flight controller is up for the training and the second one, but you are cute right now, and I don't need mission. Yeah, mission operations are not needed, so you can be flight director. Booster, spacecraft systems, navigation. And yeah, I have two booster guys standing by, so you. And I have one guy who will just sit around, because you are a better booster person. So yeah, I mean, this is a pretty awesome setup. Flight director, which isn't even trained to be a flight director, is still pretty nice, 60 points. So all of you are badasses, so I can hope that even if I have problem because of the booster is only 80 something percent, you guys might be able to just fix it. Alright, so the booster, the launch is going, okay. So that's a calculated risk. What else? We still have a lot of money. And I have one flight controller who will do nothing. But he's such a bad that I don't think I really need to train. Yeah, you are here. Should I train you? For 2.5 or 10% of conclusion, I don't think so. And you have right food for us. So yeah, you can just hang around. So yeah, what to do? I have money, but I don't have set people, so opening up new programs is meaningless. Unless I take away people from here, because yeah, the last numbers, remember, do really little. But right now, all of these are right priority. But yeah, I mean, what does a couple of persons? Yeah, this guy just gives 3% to it. really meaningless. But of course, this is. I don't remember if I talked about this before or not, but this is pretty craft system. Why? Why would we invent this way when it's obviously it's a team effort to build all of these very complicated spacecrafts. So why is it that the one guy, lead guy is very important, the second guy is least and less, and then lead and less and then very little, so no! This should be like, and why there is four people maximum, so this is quite a gamey setup for this. But yeah, this means that the third and fourth guys to the fourth guy are very meaningless. So I could open up a new program. Start working it. Well, I'm working on two projects. Yeah, but the only the Gemini spacecraft is advanced enough, and I really don't have. Yeah, I refuse to not open the Apollo program, and you guys are quite low in reliability. So even that one guy is holding quite accurately right now. So yeah, maybe not. Wait until that 10 extra people comes out of that center, and then I will open. Yeah, let's just check. What does the Apollo program? Project Apollo test flight in Earth orbit. 41,000 to open. And yeah, aha! So, this will be our Apollo command module. A lunar EVA suite, so it's not really a Apollo EVA suite, it's just a lunar EVA suite, which is the same as the Apollo. A lunar expedition module, that's the LAM. And again a target vehicle, which I am already working on. So this is the same. And of course all of these will be increased as I, probably all of these should increase as I develop Gemini and the Gemini EV. So maybe the lunar expedition module will stay at 40%. I don't know, we will see. But yeah, this will be 41,000. And this is just the Earth orbit test. What about the lunar module? That will be 47,000. Wow. Okay, so no program openings. I have one guy sitting around who really can't do anything, so it's kind of, I'm kind of ready to just launch. Yeah, let's do this. Okay, so Gemini 82, Gemini EV 49, Argeno 53. This is the important one. The Atlas will be launching with 81.1% reliability. And it have like 6 steps where it's important. The Titan 2 will be 81.4. Okay, so I have a combined reliability of 88%. I get 1000 tested on success, 750 on failure. Being on extended mission, it allows for more accurate results and provides us interesting information about the effects of long duration stay in microgravity on vertebrates organisms. Launch mission. Monitor from mission control. Here we go, strap yourself in. This will be, this might be a rocky ride.
Stand by for status, there, man.
Wow, this is the Atlas Centaur.
Turn 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fire.
Ascend. Fly, fly. Up. Yep, we have a problem. Okay. Okay, so during ascent we have a problem. We have 78% chance to fix it. For a lot of money we can increase it up to 10%. Really no point in it. And this is a non-crew mission, so yeah, I get 750 prestige loss. And a little bit, I don't know how much of reliability loss on the booster, but do not hire any teams. Yes! I thought this will be my first failure, but no. Problem solved.
Light spider, we're right on the nominal.
And now
Roger, you're on the nominal.
Okay.
Yes sir, gun tank pressure and 3 engines ready.
Okay.
Five, four, three, two, one, mark.
We did this. And during the first turn we earned 250 prestige, but this is only the start. Nice. Wow, so yeah. There must have Gigster a problem. But awesome. Minor glitch solved. Yeah, and wow, because of this successful launch, this increased 7% reliability. And you, from 95.5 to 96.5, wow. That's awesome, my guys improved. Yeah, the booster and the spacecraft system guy, the other guys not. Yet the flight controller never improves. Wow, minor glitch sword. 7% upgrade on the Atlas Centaur. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Oh, here is shows, okay. Now the question is, yeah, it's probably not, because it always says the same, so even though there is multiple step, notice the total amount they improve. The booster guy, 0.2, you guys, 0.3. And simply, the experiment guy was not involved with the launch, or the ascent, or the deployment. And the navigation guy was only involved with the deployment phase. Cool. Very cool. We are on the way to do the extended mission, and Soviets did the unscrewed suborbital flight test. Well, this is very strange, because they already did the orbital flight test, so now they did the suborbital flight test? Oh, this is strange. Also, we do not know what kind of spacecraft with they did this, because they already have the Vostok, and the Voskhod flight spacecraft opened up. The Vostok is the one-man, and the Voskhod is the two-man spacecraft. So, it's not obvious with whom they did this. It would make sense if this would be the Voskhod. If they are trying to catch up, they are skipping the Vostok and just going for the Voskhod, and they do the unscrewed suborbital flight test with it. Maybe. Yeah, Kennedy is very pleased. Unfortunately, I am not aware when did he die from that very nasty assassination. I think it might be around this time. Yeah, only a couple of years after his speech, moon speech, that was in 1961. So yeah, in any case, this would be a better timeline if you would be alive. So let's just say that we are in that timeline and you are alive, and you are, congratulations, us. But the good work, we are getting closer to the moon, and that's right. Okay, so here we are, back to our cozy launch center. Although yeah, the flight control, this should be somewhere, you know, there in Houston, but okay, it's a pretty situation. And also, this is probably not called Kennedy Launch Center, because I believe this Florida Launch Center was named Kennedy after he died. I mean, that would make sense. So probably this is not called Kennedy Flight Launch or rocket launch or whatever. Yeah, this is what happens when you record during the night. Yeah. That's okay. Concentrate on the game. So, we did the bi-satellite launch, and yeah, now I have two people available. The one booster guy who did nothing, and the other booster guy who launched. Yeah, that's okay, they will just sit around. And yeah, I don't have anything really to do. We can set on, check on this. Yeah, now the reliability improvement is very minute. Wow, nothing. This guy does nothing to it. Which means that I could use you on something else. I mean, you are not good at anything else. But yeah, I mean, starting to research another booster while this is still have plenty of capabilities to do with it doesn't make sense. And yeah, I don't have flight controllers to launch anything, so which means that it's really just time for end season. Yeah. Okay, we are improving, and let's do the second phase of the biosatellite. We already have you guys set up. school. You increased, right? You were 60%, not 61%. Which means the flight director does increase. Only it doesn't show. Okay, confirm. Resume mission. Monitor from MC. Nice. No problem at orbiting. That was kind of short. Increased now to 97.1% reliability. You and you increased nothing and you increased 0.6. And the Soviets did the lunar impact or lunar to the... I think that's the easiest mission. Luna 1 was just a flyby, so maybe not the easiest, this is the second. Yeah, I don't remember correctly, but if I remember, I remember that maybe it was Luna 2, maybe it was a later Luna, but yeah, they intended it to land and the landing failed, and that's how it became an impactor, because it hit the moon, it collided with the moon instead of just soft landing on it. So maybe this is it, and it's funny to call it an impactor when it wasn't designed to be an impactor, but maybe this was designed for an impactor and it's a later Luna that I remember, but any case. And we have people graduation from missions. Cool, we have now 49,000 megabucks. So, time to decide what to do. We have 18 people already. Flight controller. So this is kind of the A-team, the guys who are controlling the biostellite in the final stage. But we have 10 people fresh out from the set center, we have a ton of money. We have flight controllers, we have astronauts. I say this course for a launch. Launching Gemini. The question is... Yeah, this is -15%, and this is -10% only. But yeah, we should do an uncrewed suborbital flight test. The question is which rocket to use, because we can use this one too, which is already high reliability. Or should we use the one that we will use later, that have lower reliability, so its reliability goes up. Or maybe use this, so that we can free up these rocket scientists and send them on another one. And this is cheaper too to use. Yeah, let's use the safer rocket. Oh, and I didn't read all of this before. So Atlas Centaur is a highly versatile launcher, able to deploy a variety of scientific satellites in low Earth orbit or lighter payloads into translunar or transplanetary trajectories. To achieve the burn required for these various mission profiles, the Centaur upper stage uses liquid hydrogen as a fuel and liquid oxygen for an oxidizer, which gives the highest specific impulse of any known chemical and a reasonably stable rocket propellant. While this advanced technology might prove costly, its mastery can give a significant advantage when developing manned lunar expedition programs. And Buzz Aldrin, Buzzopedia. 32 meters long, 3 meters wide, weighing this many kilograms, 136,000. Just created my mating, a modified 1.5 stage Atlas D first stage with a Centaur 1 second stage. The Atlas first stage used 2 booster engines. Yeah, all technicality, this is not a technical channel. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool, very cool. And let's check the Gemini spacecraft. Gemini spacecraft features conical design, yeah, and it can be used for both suborbital and orbital crewed missions, with the possibility of performing uncrewed missions in order to validate its performance. It can also be equipped with a docking mechanism. The spacecraft, which is slightly larger than Mercury's spacecraft, is approximately 5.7 meters long with a radius of 1.5 meters at the base. Unlike Mercury though, this spacecraft has a maximum autonomy of 14 days, making it suitable for performing long duration flights in preparation for a lunar expedition. The Gemini spacecraft consists of two parts, a re-entry module and an adapter. This is the re-entry module and this is the adapter. The re-entry module was a cone-shaped two-man capsule weighting approximately 3,850 kilograms and consisting of 3 subsections. This section contained at the forward part of the re-entry module was the rendezvous and recovery section. This section contained the radar and locking mechanisms for docking, as well as the dog, pilot, and the main parachutes. Located between the air and air section and the cabin section was the re-entry control system section. The FGS section housed fuel, oxidizer and 16 thrusters for the re-entry control system. The final and largest section was the cabin. This was a pressurized titanium hull covered by a beryllium shell. An ablative heat shield was attached to the aft end of the cabin. The cabin housed the 2 crew positions, flight controls and instrumentation. Unlike the Mercury capsule, the Gemini capsule used ejection seats to separate the crew from the capsule during an emergency. Voice communication for most of the flight was provided by 1 high frequency and 2 ultra high frequency transmitters. Originally, 3 telemetry transmitters and 4 beacons were included in the communication suite for use during the flight and recovery phases. Power was supplied by batteries in Gemini 1, 2, 4. Gemini 5 and subsequent flights used fuel cells as a primary power source during most of the flights. Switching to batteries as the primary power source during the re-entry and recovery phases. The second part of the Gemini spacecraft was the adapter section. This mated the capsule, once again mated, interesting choice of word. This mated the capsule to the launch vehicle and consisted of 2 sections, the equipment section, located at the aft portion of the adapter, containing fuel cells, batteries, oxygen tanks and electrical components. It also contained the fuel for the orbit altitude and maneuvering system, and 10 thrust assemblies for use in orbital maneuvers. A gold fiber glass temperature control, cover the open end of the adapter to protect the equipment from solar radiation. The equipment section would be jettisoned prior to their orbiting. The second section of the adapter was the retrograde section located at the forward end of the adapter section. This contained four solid fuel retrorockets for deorbiting, as well as six thrust assemblies. This section would be jettisoned after the firing of the retrorockets. Nice. So, this will be 90% reliable. And you will be 88% reliable. So it's quite safe to launch you. The question really is, should I use the Titan to restart it? It's just 700 more. Hopefully 700 is not ammonia at this stage. Yeah. No, I will need to use you anyway when I will do suborbital flight. So no, it is safe to use you, the Atlas Centaur, and I will use that. Now I really think. I don't need to. I could just do orbital flight test immediately. That's just minus 10%. I could do this. It would give us minus 10% reliability. But I would be able to skip two steps. Yeah, I mean, this doesn't give much prestige anyway. Kind of a waste of time and money. Choices. Well, Soviet did an uncrewed suborbital flight test that I assume to be the equivalent of the Gemini, which means that they are trying to catch up. So I would say, oh, I am ahead, I don't need to rush. But what if I do need to rush? To this minus 10%. How many steps are you? 12. That's quite a lot. Yeah. I better not skip. Better get to this uncrewed suborbital flight test, yeah. But then I could use the booster because I don't need to be afraid of the Titan 2. Yeah, let's use the Titan 2. Even though I could I could save 700 money and the other one have better reliability, but I will have to use you when I have to use a manned flight, so yeah, schedule the mission. Okay, there are quite many people needed here. Flight. You are my best flight controller. You are the second best flight controller. Booster. Repo. Fido. Guido. Ecom. Network. Procedures. Confirm. 7,000 to launch. Okay. So that's that. Meanwhile, the fire satellite is still going on. This will be the final turn. Okay. So that's settled. We will do one good flight test. Uncrewed suborbital flight test first. We'll do it safe. But we'll use the Titan. Titan 2. Instead of the last Centaur. So that gets up in reliability too. Now next question. What to do with the other guy? We have 7 astronauts ready. Next turn I could use 3 of them, 4 of them are still not required. I also have 10 sad people doing nothing, I really could use them, or train them. So yeah, on Earth orbit I could open the orbiting fog hopolit. What point you would have? You would get us some nice easy prestige. Also there is the Luna. Probably I should concentrate it on the Moon. Yeah, so they did the lunar impactor, so now doing you is really kind of useless. Because yeah, I could only be the second to do it. Says 2300, but oh yeah, because of goals, yeah. But what goals can you have? I mean, you can have these, but this study and close-up pictures I can get with these two. So no, I don't need you. Yes, I could open the lunar orbiting program. Although there's only 2 programs, 2 goals that I can get that I don't have already. But I kind of need you because the survey would start at lower reliability. So yeah, with the Bias satellite I just catch up and now I'm doing something extended mission that the Soviet didn't. So I could do the same, just catching up with the Ranger 3 lunar impactor, but no, I could get the lunar orbiter. Yes. Let's open it up. Okay. And so I saw I need to play around. You are the best newborn here. You? Second best girl here. You. Easy peasy. You will get up to 79%. Nice. I still have 6 sad people. Very doing nothing. What are the other people, by the way? Humiliated rocket. Rocket. I guess I could just train them. Because yeah, I really don't have any more good physical people, and rocket wise. I mean, yeah, you guys only give 1 more percent at least. But do I really need to open up a new rocket program? No. No, I do not. Although there is the Saturn 1 booster, which is exactly just for the Pegasus satellite. Although that's of course quite skippable too. Even this other 2 Titan is 75% starting, so yeah, I mean the Saturn 1 and Titan 3 is also skip up, where I can just go straight for the Titan Heat Center work. Yeah, this can do anything space probe wise as I could ever want. But yeah, I mean, I probably this is just a Pioneer 3400. Transplanetary, so I already can do anything, you know, with my current booster. The only transplanetary is the defense. What can 600 can bring that 3400 can do? That's the question. I mean, this I can already do with this one, so obviously not. 600 versus 34. You are under 600 from Merk, I can get to Mercury with the basic one. Oh, I didn't check if I can do it. Yeah, I can do it with the one I have right now too. What about Venus? I can do all of the 3 with the picture I have right now too. And I can do the Lunar too, all of them too. This obviously not. Yeah. Oh, Mars. You cannot do the Viking. Yeah, that's 1500. So for that I need the Titan. But these 2 I can already do. And yeah, probably the Pioneers. No, I can do the Pioneers. I can do the Pioneers with this one, so I really not need any more. Wow! So the only thing that I cannot launch probe twice is the Viking launchers. That's 1500. So yeah, for that you need the Titan 3E Zento. So the only unique use of this is that. Which means there is really no use for you, Titan 3E. I mean, I guess, you know, I could use you to launch space rods, but yeah. So yeah, and Saturn 1 is for 9,000 that I cannot launch with my current one, yeah. 9,000 to go to orbit, but by the way, I could use that Saturn 5 to launch it, but that would be a overkill. And there's a Saturn 1B. Only low Earth orbit, so probably this is... Yeah, this is probably for the Apollo test on Earth orbit, the Saturn 1B. Let's check, it says 21,000. So let's check the weight of the Apollo. It's 30... Oh, no, it's 30... wait, that's... I don't get it. For suborbit 30,000, but for Leo it... Oh, I see, okay. So Leo is Leo is between 19,000 and suborbit 30. So let's go back. Right, I am right. So yeah, this Saturn 1B is for testing out the Apollo in Earth orbit. This can bring it up to suborbital and also to low Earth orbit. Yeah, and the Saturn 5 is for launching it to the moon. So yeah, I will need you for Earth orbit test, but you can also launch. You can also launch the Pegasus satellite on Earth orbit, that's 9,000. That would be the only use of this booster. The only job it can have, that special job. So yeah, and you are needed for that Viking London, and then which means that you are completely useless, because there is everything else that I can do it with my current booster. So yeah, I really am checking what I can skip. You are probably for Gemini moon mission. Yeah, you can probably probably you can bring the Gemini into something moon mission. But yeah, for going on the traditional historical route, all I need to get is the Saturn 1B for Earth orbit test, and then the Saturn 5 for the moon mission. Yeah, I can completely skip the Viking. There is no need for me to do the Viking orbiter. Yeah. Yeah. I'm doing very well. Yeah, I don't need to research any more rockets than you, really. You are perfectly fine for all of my needs except one. You are good for Gemini, and then I can get the Saturn 1B and then the Saturn 5, and that's moon. So yeah, I'm closer to the moon landing than I actually think. Yeah, with the Gemini I will have to test out many things, and I'm starting out quite slow, but I can basically launch every mission, every turn I can launch. Okay. So, we will do the unscrew suborbital. And we open the... We open the lunar orbiter. Cool. What else to do? Not really anything. Let's just check the lunar orbiter. Just curious. This. 9 steps. So yeah, moon approach, and then instead of lunar impact, it's lunar orbit. So it's not any more difficult, the mission itself, than the lunar impact, but it gets so much more results. Okay. Yeah, I think I really need space probe guys more, because I really can't do anything with my rocket and human-rated rocket guy, because I am pretty close to finishing. I already have enough people for that, but space probes, there is more to research in that. So let's check my guys. Yeah, I could research many space probes at once. So yeah, that's what I really need to do, not immunated rockets. Yeah. So you are already trained at EVA. Aha! Right. I forgot about this too. Now I have such guys who have finished their training, so they might be better than few who are already employed. Okay, so let's check everything. Start from the core. And you are quite good at something else too. Yeah, you are already high, so you are not priority, but priority is much on low reliability, so EV is sweet. Yeah, guess the 4 best TVA guy here. Yeah. Okay. And then space probes. Do it like this. Yes, good space capsule, you are not good. You are rocket guy, so not that good. You are rocket guy too. So any of you are very good at space probes, you are quite good. and I could use these lesser mines, because there is really not much to increase here, to improve my space probe research. Yeah, you guys, might be better. Yeah, here we go. Okay. So yeah, I still have the 6 guys who are not doing anything, and yeah, I really don't have anything for them to do. Really, opening up Saturn is not yet meaningful. But if I would open up the Apollo, it's way too early. So yeah, we have to train these guys. Hmm? How are you here with 89%? Did I make a mistake? We are 89% at good spacecraft. Yeah. How did I miss you? I have no idea, somehow. Okay, at least I noticed it here at training. So yeah, I have you, 69% learn ability. And look at here, all the people who should be way better. 91%, very high starting skills. I mean, why don't I have you instead of that person? No. Yeah, and I already trained you. What a waste of money. Yeah, I am going to fire you because I don't need more cool spacecraft guy, and you have low morale, with not really, but medium morale and very low learning capacity. So yeah, I am going to fire you. How horrible of me, I know. And I will hire you. 95, learning capacity, and already a very good baseline. I mean, I need space probe guys, and you are the best. So yeah, you are in. I can't hire more, but that's okay. Yeah, and you will need to go to basic training, but still I will be more ahead this way. Okay. That's settled. I have 9 flight controllers still ready. Well, if I will do the Octua flight, that will be 11. And 2 more. I could send 7 and still be ready to launch. Oh, and these you guys will be free next turn, right? One, two, three, 4 guys will be free. So yeah, I can send everyone to train, really. And payloads, and yeah, I can get them. So you will be one of the guys, obviously, that I will use. And you Discuss systems. Yeah, let's train more. Train, train, train. Trajectory. Trajectory. Crew and payload. Oh yeah, you are already high enough and you have okay morale. Mission operations. Trajectory. And you have very good propulsion, so yeah. I'm sorry you are sitting this out. Yeah, I really don't need two propulsion guys. I mean, one of them is basically a reserve. Maybe if I will, yeah, maybe, yeah, I will, yes. I do need two propulsion guys because I will launch two spacecrafts. Yeah. For rendezvous. Okay, trajectory. Review. Spacecraft systems. Full. There's two guys who are not doing everything and they are very good. Okay, seven astronauts. So. I need three for a launch, two in the spacecraft, one in Capcom, plus I have to remember that if I want to do back-to-back missions, the two are resting, so I need five to be able to do back-to-back missions. Which is still very much available with 7 astronauts, but yeah, this is the baseline building. Good upgrade, you. Put 400 more maintenance cost and the salary of the guys, astronauts, right? So I could double the employees, so instead of 714 astronauts. And you guys have quite high salary, 50. So let's say 50 multiplied 7. Sorry, I'm not a mathematician and I'm not operating at maximum efficiency right now, tonight. But yeah, really, that's not hard. 50 times 7. That's 350. Yeah. That's not a lot. So yeah, I could increase you, and then I would have 14 astronauts, which means that I could train them and yeah, have available supply, because yeah, remember, if I have a catastrophic failure, then these astronauts are gone, and the 4 students will have basic training, then I need to do all the audience training to get them to be actually good. So yeah, I am doing this. I am upgrading this to the second level. It will take 2 turns to be upgraded, and then 4 more turns to have the astronauts ready after basic training. So yeah, this is quite a long-term investment, but yeah. Right now I still can do it with 7 astronauts, I have 2 spare. If I want to do back-to-back mission, that's 5 astronauts. 2 flying, 2 rest season and 1 Capcom. So I have exactly 2 reserves, but yeah, but once I get astronauts, Apollo, that will be 3 crew, and then 7 would be just enough to back to back missions. 3 flying, 3 on rest season, and 1 is back home. Yeah, that would be quite dangerous. So yeah, this is about the right time to start to upgrade it, I believe. Yeah, if you consider that I will have to do all the advanced trainings too. Yeah, by the time you get to Apollo, they might be ready. Okay? So I still have the question that I have 7 astronauts ready. I don't need 7 astronauts, even if I will fly back to back, I only need 5, which means that 2 is available for training. Yeah. So you are my Capcom guy, but I will need you, and you are my elite guy, and I will need you, and I will need a second guy who is piloting, you could beat. So yeah, I need to select 2 guys who will not do much, who I will send on training. I mean, you could beat. I don't need science guy yet. So I could train you. More fitness, more science, maybe EVA. Let's get science above 90. Okay, and I need to select one more guy to send on training. The lowest fitness is you, but you will be my Capcom. But if I send you on training, who could be Capcom? You could be Capcom. Right, you are not that worse, 15% less. Oh, but no, I don't need to send you on training. Because you are the Capcom, although I could send you on training to leadership. That would increase you above 90%. Right, and then you could be the Capcom. Yeah, let's send you in training for leadership. Okay. Okay, that's set up. And yeah, everything is set up. I have very much money. Don't really have more programs to open. Yeah. Space probes, I could open more, but yeah, I could open more because these are just doing very little. 5. This, yeah, the third last guy is doing something at least, but the last guy is doing nothing, so I could open up a new space probe program. Question is, what space program could I already start on Surveyor? Not yet. Yeah, because you know, it's not 75% yet. Yeah, I should only open it once Lunar Orbiter is complete. I could do the frog. Would give us nice prestige and easy mission. Something that the Soviet didn't do yet. Although I'm not sure if they have the equivalent research. Yeah, let's do the probe, open up the probe program. We'll use the title 2. And let's put the 2 researchers here. Although now I have to resuffle all of you once again. So yeah, primary dog in a target vehicle, so the best comes here, then you here, than the third best here. Then one here. Then one here. And then one here. And then two comes here. So you are 72%, you are 78, you are 79. Nice. Okay. So we are researching three space probe programs at once. The Agena target vehicle, the lunar, the advanced lunar orbiter, and the frog. Why do we need to research amphibians on orbit when we're already sending up humans? Don't ask me, but we get the prestige. So. Okay, so yeah, let's do. We will have two missions now, finishing up the biosatellite if we are returned to orbit, and launching our own group suborbital Gemini flight test. Let's go. What could go wrong? So Gemini is 88%, and what we need to check is the Titan 2, because that's what I will use, 86.8%. Okay, so let's land the Paris satellite. Oh, I can't check. But yeah, it will be multiple steps because we will re-enter with the research section. It will land. So it will be multiple steps now. Okay. Interesting question. Should we use the best guys here? Because if we use it now, I can't use it for the... We can't use it for the Gemini. Right. So maybe I should not use the best guy. Although, interestingly, it says that now you are the best guy, not you. Right. I might need to reserve the best guys. So yeah. The current payloads. Oh, I only have you guys available? Yeah, because I see. So never mind. Because I already set up. So yeah, I could change it now, but those guys I already set up to do the Gemini launch, so I can't. Okay, so yeah, never mind. Confirm. Do it. Monitor from MC. Here we go. Let's bring those critters back home. And easy peasy, we did the extended mission. That's 500 prestige. Now it's 97.6%, but of course the biosatellite is completely used. Interestingly, the Atlas Central booster didn't improve that all. Oh, I'm stupid. Because we didn't use this here, okay. And the flight controllers improved a little bit. The experiment guys. Okay. So this is the bigger deal, uncrewed suborbital flight test. Okay, so this will be the Titan 2. Okay, here we go. This is the important.
T-minus 90 seconds and counting. All systems still looking good.
Where is the rocket? Ah, there. Okay.
The Titan 2 launch vehicle will ignite 3 seconds later than check. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fire.
Nice. Uh-oh. We have a problem with the capsule itself during suborbital flight. Uh-oh. Network is working on it. Or there is a problem with the network. Could hire a tiger team, but yeah. No, this is just the flight test. I mean, if it fails, it fails. Yeah, I mean, this 5%, this is very minute increase. Do not hire, let's do it. And we did it. Problem solved. And we did it. Okay, that's nice. Let's see the increase in reliability. Okay, we did the uncrewed suborbital flight test. Mm-hmm. Okay, 5% on the Titan, 5% on the Gemini. Okay, nice. Titan is 92% reliable. Gemini is 93%. You guys increased too. Cool. Very cool. Aha! They did the Vostok. Okay. Cool. So they did the suborbital flight test. And the uncrewed orbital flight test again. And then they did the Vostok suborbital flight. Man in space. There, this is the Vostok, not the Voskhod. Oh, yeah, I fired you. Employee termination. Okay. Increased in public interest prestige. The astronaut center is improving, upgrading. Cool. We did it. We are way ahead of the Soviets. They just did the Vostok suborbital flight. Something we did what, 3 years ago? Yeah. So we are way ahead of the Soviets. We are very safe. Yeah, they did the Barrett satellite ahead of us. And they did the Lunar Impactor. But we are getting ahead of them in that aspect too. We did the Barrett-Satellite extended mission. We are doing the Frog now, and we will do the advanced moon orbiter instead of just impactor. So yeah, we are ahead of the Soviets quite comfortably. So next time we'll do actual launch of a manned vehicle, hopefully. And we are getting closer to the moon indeed. I hope you enjoyed the mission and the game. I too enjoyed it. See you next time.